In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brothers and sisters, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's Gospel. It's the 22nd of September, and today we celebrate the 25th Sunday in ordinary time, year C. The Holy Gospel according to Luke, chapter 16, verses from 1 to 13. At that time, Jesus said to the disciples, "There was a rich man who had a steward, and charges were brought to him that this man was wasting his goods. And he called him and said to him, 'What is this that I hear about you? Turn in the account of your stewardship, for you can no longer be steward.' And the steward said to himself, 'What shall I do, since my master is taking the stewardship away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do, so that people may receive me into their houses when I am put out of the stewardship.' So summoning his master's debtors one by one, he said to the first, 'How much do you owe my master?' He said, 100 measures of oil. And he said to him, 'Take your bill and sit down quickly and write 50. Then he said to another, "And how much do you owe?" He said, 100 measures of wheat. He said to him, "Take your bill and write 80. The master commended the dishonest steward for his prudence. For the sons of this world are wiser in dealing with their own generation than the sons of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of unrighteous mammon, so that when it fails, they may receive you into the eternal habitations. He who is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much, and he who is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. If then you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will entrust to you the true riches? And if you have not been faithful in that which is another's, who will give you that which is your own? No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today, my dear friends, we are brought by our readings into the complicated world of Christian responsibility regarding wealth, business and politics. The parable we have in the gospel is difficult to interpret. The dishonest steward displays a canny ability and acts in such a way that the debtors feel duty bound to welcome him in their houses. Jesus concludes the story praising the steward for his ability. And it is here that we find ourselves in difficulty. How can he propose a dishonest person as a model to be imitated? Let us bear in mind that to praise the shrewdness of a person is not to approve also what that person does. This astuteness has nothing to do with issues of right and wrong. The master commends his manager's ability to find a solution. Before drawing some conclusions, let us take a glance at the first reading of today from the prophet Amos. Prophet Amos, who is also called the prophet of social justice. You need to read chapter 8, verses 4 to 7. What does he say? It is taken from a section. The section is from chapter 7 to 9 of five visions that were granted to him by God concerning Israel. They are a swarm of locusts, a fire, a measuring plumb line, a basket of ripe fruit, and a sanctuary. All five visions indicate that Israel has not been faithful to their relationship with God. They signal the coming destruction of Israel and Samaria because they do not measure up. A passage comes soon after the vision of a basket of fruit. The fruit in the basket is rotten, and so is Israel in the eyes of the prophet. The prophet rebukes the leaders and the wealthy people of his time for their heartless behavior. Their wealth brought along two things: moral corruption and idol worship. It's true even today. Once profit is established as the guiding principle, minor details such as fraudulent weights, inflated prices, and poor quality merchandise can easily be rationalized and even justified. It is here Amos throws a spanner in the works, that God sees all this and takes note of it. It is hardly surprising that the Lord takes an oath never to forget such abominable sins. That oath is an inflexible as Israel's pride. Never will I forget a single thing you have done. God says, never will I forget a single thing you have done. Now let us listen to once again to Jesus, who draws a lesson by telling his hearers, "For the children of this world, are more prudent in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. That means that if only the Christian was as eager and ingenious in his attempt to attain goodness as a person of the world is in his or her attempt to attain money and comfort, he or she would be a better person. If only people would give as much attention to the things which concern their soul as they rightfully do to the things which concern their business, they would be better people. So in one word, my dear friends, we ought to put our astuteness to do good. Learn to think unconventionally. Display your creativity in as many situations as possible. The more we try, the more we will be creatively inclined. Why don't you, like the dishonest steward, think of something novel and unique in doing good? Often they don't cost us anything. It's only putting to use our skills and talents that are lying latent or dormant or are being used for wrong purposes. St. Paul, in the second reading, in his letter, first letter to Timothy, chapter 2, verses 1 to 8, takes up public prayer for all people, but practically or particularly for those in positions of authority. The powerful also need our prayers, not our judgment. The courageous Christian may, in charity, point out their erring ways to those who do ill, but judgment itself is left to the Almighty. Certainly, we are reminded in this reading to pray, not just for wrongdoers, but for all in authority, whether in church — we have corrupt leaders in the church too — or state. Their power is in itself a dangerous temptation from which they need God's grace to be safe. Paul is writing to his young apprentice, Timothy, who himself, as Paul's assistant and sometime representative, would have been involved in the administration of some of the young churches. Let us pray. Thomas K.L. Devsi from Thane, Mumbai. Matthew Nirmal Kumar from Kuwait. Selvin Lopez Kumta. Richard D'Souza from Nityadharnagar, Mangalore. Denzel D'Souza from Karkal are celebrating their birthdays. We wish them happy birthday and we pray God's choicest blessings on them. One of them is Matthew Nirmal Kumar, who has also adopted two of our seminarians. We acknowledge his generosity and we thank him in a special way. It's also the wedding anniversary of Edric and Vinita Mendonca from Shirwa. Congratulations, my dear couple. May God bless your family life. Let's pray. O Lord, may I use my gifts and talents creatively to gain eternal life. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stifan Perera, Carmelite priest. My WhatsApp number is 94812-63229. 94812-63229. See you tomorrow. Have a great Sunday. Bye-bye.